Hi everybody, today I am going to teach about the poem that is in 12th standard, the first unit, first poem, The Castle. Castle is written by Edwin Moore. Edwin Moore was born in 1887 on a farm in Dearness in Scotland. When Moore was 14, his father lost his land and the whole family had to move to Glasgow, an industrial town in England. He received shock after shock after he moved to Glasgow. The cultural shock after moving to the serene countryside. And then within 2 years, he lost his father, mother, and 2 brothers. He had to take care of himself in that tender age itself. And he worked in a factory and rose slowly to the level of a dignitary. So he often find the themes loss and betrayal in his works. Let's see the summary of the poem. All through that summer at ease we lay, and daily from the turret wall we watched the movers in the hay and the enemy half a mile away. They seemed no threat to us at all, for what we thought had we to fear. With our arms in provender, load on load, our towering battlements, tire on tire, and friendly allies drawing near. On every leafy summer road, our gates were strong, our walls were thick, so smooth and high no man could win. A foothold there, no clever trick could take us dead or quick. Only a bird could have got in. What could they offer us for bat? Our captain was brave and we were true. There was a little private gate, a little wicket gate. The wizened warder led them through. Oh, then a maze of tunnel stone grew thin and treacherous as air. The cause was lost without a groan, the famous citadel overthrown, and all his secret galleries bare. How can this shameful tale be told? I'll maintain until my death. We could do nothing being sold. Our only enemy was gold, and we had no arms to fight with. Here, the poet highlights the confidence of the soldiers and the strength of the castle. Throughout the half of the poem, he says he is very proudly saying about the strength of the castle, how it was built. There's no chance at all. And he also has the confidence on the soldiers as well as his captain. So let's see. This poem is a monologue. It's in the form of a monologue. A soldier himself is saying something about that. And one of the soldiers who witnessed the rise and the downfall of the castle narrates what happened to the castle in the point of view. So let's pass on to the poem. In the first 2 stanzas, the soldier describes the mighty castle and the mindset of the inhabitants of the castle. The tone of the poem is very relaxed and stress-free. The soldier here says, it was a summer season. Everybody in the castle was relaxed, and so the soldiers also. They lay and watched the movers in the hay. The word hay lay refers to the relaxed and fearless mood of the soldiers. Mewing of the grass explains how they maintained the exterior of the castle. So here it says, all through that summer at ease we lay, that is relaxedly laying down over there, and daily from the turret. Turret here means a small turret is the small tower on the top of the castle. The top of the castle is a small tower. And we watch the movers in the hay. Movers, the play people who trim the grass. And the enemies half a mile away, they seem no threat to us at all. Then the enemies was half the mile away. And from the top of the castle, one could see to some extent, since the castle was built in a high place, soldiers could see at least half a mile, and they cannot spot any enemies within a half a mile radius. How will an enemy usually attack? They approach with a big battalion of forces, and if they had to attack a mighty castle like this castle, the enemy will need more soldiers on the side. They seem no threat to us at all. That means the soldiers in the castle believed that there was no chance of danger because the castle was expertly built. The physical strength of the castle gives them a supreme feeling of the protection. The second stanza, for what we thought had we to fear, with our arms and provender load on load, our towering battlements tier on tier, and friendly allies drawing near on every leafy summer load. It means they had best weapons to attack the enemies, and they also had more than enough food stored in the castle. Even if the castle gets besieged from outside, they can survive with the inside the castle for months together. They had food for themselves and also for animals like horses and all. That is, here in this stanza, we refer to the soldiers and provender. Provender means food, arms in the sense, weapons, and towering battlement is an opening in the top to shoot arrows towards the enemies. Child after child, it's one above the other. And friendly allies is the supporting nations. See the third stanza. And here, battlements, our gates were strong, our walls were thick, so smooth and high no man could bend a foothold there, no clever trick could take us dead or quick, only a bird could have got in. See, here in the third stanza, battlements, it's the small opening on the top of the wall. In the second stanza, it's given battlements, top of the wall for shooting the arrows. Here are towering battlements, tier on tier. That is, on every level of the castle, it's all told in the second stanza, battlements, towering battlements and all, tier on tier. That is, on the every level of the castle, the battlement and their friendly allies were ready to come and help them anymore. See the third stanza, nobody can break their gate because they were so strong and the walls were so thick and the walls were so smooth and high that no one can climb on it. Foothold here means no one can get a grip on the leverage which they use to conquer the castle. This shows how meticulous the castle was built, considering every aspect of an enemy attack. The soldier also says no one can enter the castle and capture them alive or dead. Only a bad bird can enter the castle because the castle is built on such a high place. That is the third stanza. And see the fourth stanza, what could they offer? They offer us the bait. Our captain was brave and we were true. There was a little private gate, a little wicket gate. The vision warder led them through. See, bite here means the captain, he was a very brave man. And wicked is evil, and wicked gate is a small gate inside. Vision warder is the old god who takes care of the castle. See, there is a rhetorical question in this stanza from the soldier. What could they offer as for the belt? So the confidence also comes from the fact that their captain was a brave man, and all the soldiers were very much true and loyal to him. Then there is a pause, a change in the mode of the poem. In the fourth and fifth line, he repeats the word gate twice. There is a small gate aside, a little private gate, and there was an old guard who is disloyal, greedy, and corrupt. One of the old inhabitants had betrayed them. They were prepared for an attack, but what happened was an invasion. See the fifth stanza. Oh, then our maze of tunnel stone grew thin and treacherous as air. The cause was lost without a groan. The famous rattle overthrown and all its secret galleries bare. Here maze is a confusing path. Once a person enters the, it will be very confused that he cannot come outside. That is maze. And treacherous is disloyal. Citadel, it's a safe and strong fort. Overthrown here is defeated, lamented. Okay? Galleries bare is lost all the glory. See the meaning of this. Now, here in the fifth stanza, now the tone of the poem is helplessness. The same walls which provided them confidence is not preventing them from the escaping from the castle now. They are now trapped inside. The whole castle looks like a maze. That is a confusing path from which they cannot come out. The walls grow thin and treacherous like air. They feel lost and they lose the purpose of staying in the castle. The walls are not protecting them. It has lost its purpose. Now, we understand the soldiers' confidence came from the physical strength of the castle. They had always presumed they were stronger than their enemies. Without any opposition, the enemies takes control of the castle. The soldiers witnesses a major political change. Once the castle was famous for its glory, now it looks barely and empty. This bare galleries here refers to the lost of the galleries. And let's see the last stanza, the sixth stanza of the poem. How can this shameful tale be told? I will maintain until my death. We could do nothing being sold. Our only enemy was gold, and we had no arms to fight with. And here also, maintain is the belief. And here, the poet again brings out a rhetorical question. They did not fight, they did not lose their battle, they were endangered by their own inhabitants, and this is a very shameful act for a soldier. He does not want to disclose about this to anyone till he dies. They were sold, and he cannot accept that they lost and could not escape from there. He feels helpless. And he says, gold is the only enemy. He refers to the bribe received by the old god. And the soldier tells, this is his own layman word. Gold here refers to the greed and lack of moral strength. Okay, now we can discuss about the poetic devices and figure of speeches which are found in this poem. The rhyming words found here is A, B, A, A, B. Rhyming scheme is A, B, A, A, B. That is, here we see lay, hay, then away, wall, all. So all this says that the rhyming scheme of the poem is A, B, A, A, B. For example, in the first stanza, I can see the words lay, hay, away. This says that the scheme is A, B, A, A, B. And again, we find the alliterated words also here. Alliterated words, all the first letters of the each word should be the same, isn't it? So alliteration also is found over here. Then we find metaphor, that is, the form of the castle can be compared to the individual human being who can fall from his high position because of the small flaw in his character. So we find a metaphor also here. See, the wizened water let them throw. Here comes the metaphor. And we find imagery also here. The imagery is O, then one maze of tunneled stone grew into thin and treacherous air here. This is imagery. And a personification is also found here. That is gold. Gold is the personification. Our only enemy was gold. Gold here is the qualities of a human being is told over here. So this is personification we are finding. And at last, the rhetorical questions the poet arises is, the soldier asked, what could they offer for bite? And how can this shameful tale be told? These are the two rhetorical questions asked by the poet in the last stanza. And the word gate is used twice here. That is the repetition. And in the entire poem, the words we, S is used as several times. So this is about the poem. This is a monologue, and the poet highlights the confidence of the soldiers as well as the strength of the poem. I think all would have understood very well. And if you like this explanation of the poem, please like this and share to many of your friends, and please do not forget to subscribe also. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.